Ladies and Germans, how y'all doing? This is Conalric.
I'm Ring Ru, lo lo lo.
And folks, as we go further and further towards Memorial Day, let's remember this match today over here on Babor, right? Who's fighting and what with?
On left hand side in blue, we have Sean playing Korok 559 with a balanced income. And on the right hand side, we have Solo Ring Pixie playing as the 1st Polish Infantry Division with a Vanguard income. And this is another match from the Steel Division Championship, the 2nd Championship.
Kind of nice to see the championship. You know, actually, like you mentioned to me just before we got started today, guys, we just received word of actually some new divisions joining us on, you know.
Not... six?
Yes, exactly. So I'm not even going to try to do the math. Was it the 76th anniversary of the invasion, I believe? Might be wrong.
Been a long time.
It's been, yeah, it's certainly been a while. I wasn't alive at that point. It was only a couple years after that I came into this world, like, you know, 40 or 50. But as we, of course, get started here, Shupo's going across the river, eschewing the use of any kind of bridge. Like, you know what? We don't care if we have, we got our waders on.
Yeah, they can just, you know, go through the river. And I do like seeing this early aggressive play. I mean, we got Sean with Shupo blob up north, run in the middle. I mean, real map like this, you kind of just have to rush across the river and hope for the best. And that's what Solo Ring's doing as well, but a little bit more of a mechanized force down south.
You know, it is kind of incredible. I did not expect that all of that kind of field artillery just to completely shred those poor machine guns, but they are pinned down and slaughtered.
Hey, those infantry guns are in an absolutely lovely position. We are seeing some gun runs here with the JU-87, and that can make some pretty short work for those field guns. You can see, but oh, he's being chased down by an IL-2 and he gets shot down.
Yes, it does. And the southern approach is completely in red control at this point. Kind of looking elsewhere to see how the rest of that kind of struggle is going. To the north, the Shupos are doing okay. They have a Fuhrer, of course, but with Stroki SVTs moving on in, I don't know how long they're going to be holding.
Yeah, they're going to be holding pretty well. I mean, it's always with, you know, disheartened spam. Yes, you get a lot of dudes, but they just don't really ever do that much damage.
Yes.
Especially against, you know, Soviet infantry, which was, for the most part, real Polis, I should say. Really relic crit.
They certainly are. I'm actually kind of surprised. You would have thought that the Soviets would have just sent them in with just, you know, harsh language and pitchforks, but they actually armed them. I'm surprised. Well, looking also down to the center side here, there are a couple of light vehicles, SPW on the Germans, excuse me, on the German side, as well as a BA-10 over here on the Poles. It's kind of amusing to me to think about how light the early mechanization here is, or isn't, as the case might be.
Mm-hmm. It's just, you know, a few T-34s here from Solar, which is definitely going to help out, especially against Korok, which they get a lot of tanks, but not a lot of good tanks.
Yes.
Yeah, it's just whatever they can muster. This is a really good push from Solo. I mean, going through that, like, middle northern forest, yeah, with all the close quarters infantry, you know, holding the area is good. He's got foothold down south. He still has to deal with the middle approach, where Sean is moving all the Shupos. But, you know, it's only to start some troops. I think it's going to be too much of an issue.
I confess, I was actually watching the north. It's just that this new column of Shupos came on in. And I'm really, really surprised that the Strokis have not been more, we'll say, effective in pushing them out.
Yeah, same here. I mean, a lot of these are the SVT-equipped runs, so they usually do a pretty good job. But there's just so many of them, I guess. It takes them a little bit to kill.
It certainly does. They're falling back from the center crossing here. So maybe the beginnings of a pocket is going to be formed around the blue aggression. I don't know. All I do know is you don't bet on the guys with their hearts wearing worn on their sleeves.
Mm-hmm. Let's see when they cracked.
Exactly. Exactly. You gotta have a doctor look at that, man. Cardiologist or something.
Yeah, it's really... I mean, the problem with all these SS Shupos is that they also don't have any anti-tank weaponry. I mean, down south here, this BA-10's just running around loose because there's literally not a single AT gun nearby to blow it up.
True, but it's also fair to say that this BA-10 doesn't have a whole lot of efficacy either because he's out of HE, so...
That's a, you know... Voices complain through two machine guns.
Well, it's a six of one, half a dozen of another kind of thing. And a cluster? We have a cluster bomb. Oh, wow, so T-34, so say TI-34, it's been doing too much math recently. But we have an IL-2 making a run over here on these T-34s down to the south from the German side, even as one of these brave, brave field guns goes down. This could be a double kill.
That could be. Sean is spreading them out. That was a good call. So he should only lose one. Yeah. Pretty acceptable math.
True, but one out of two is still a fail. Up to the north, a couple of SBWs being brought on in. But there still is a T-34 hanging out behind this hillside. I can't wait to see what happens when he kind of reveals himself. Even as these shoot posts in the center do, in fact, get cut off. And they'll, who cares? If they're behind enemy lines, they're behind enemy lines.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think Sean really needs to start investing a little bit more in armor and more potent high-explosive weaponry. All he really is doing is spamming infantry. So yeah, JU is a good call. Coming in for the T-34.
I think the IL-2 is coming after it.
Yep.
Wait, the
IL-2 needs to like drop its bomb so it can actually catch up.
I don't know. The JU-87, I think, is going to be greedy, and that's going to be its downfall.
Yep. Going to be flying right over AA, but the anti-air does get killed, Joe.
Wait, is there a 12-7 out? There's a 37mm out, okay.
They hold our damn south.
Oh my god, this is like the most depressing gun run ever, okay.
Yeah, still having a bomb load on the IL-2 means it's a little bit too slow to chase up to the JU-87.
But he did what he needed to do. He freaked out the enemy and he's taking a bit of a break now.
Yeah. Time out, you know. Gonna go back to base, have a smoke, and come back for round two.
Yes, sir. But meanwhile, while he's been kind of futzing around with that JU-87, looking elsewhere, there's still a T-34 in the south that has not been taken out courtesy of that cluster bomber, but I don't know if he's gonna be long for this world, and no, he is not getting taken out by his opposing number.
I always like how in this game, when he says a T-34, you always gotta double check. Which side, German or Russian? That's not just like this matchup, but for a lot of matchups.
Well, I admit I'm looking forward to having to say that about the Western divisions as well, too. Mm-hmm.
This would be pretty fun. I mean, as we've seen so far, 2nd Infantry and 17th, that they're getting new units from their SC-44 counterparts, which will definitely spice things up.
We were talking about the SS Legionari.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Wait, another gun run to the north. JU-87. Are we seeing legitimate fighters now? Nope, just more IL-2s.
Yeah, Cork's definitely... I do like how he is relying a lot of his air power. That's really one of the key strengths of Cork, is you've got all those 87s to do strafing gun runs on really anything you so desire. Against Poles forever, they kind of just have too much stuff. Like, you don't have enough gun runs to deal with that amount of infantry. And as we know with ST2, it really just comes down to infantry spam in the end of the day.
Well, that's one part I was going to make the comment, but the second thing I was going to say, though, too, is that while it's awesome to have all of those ground attack planes, you kind of need to establish some kind of air control. He's been really lucky so far that Solo Wing Pixie has not aggressively pushed air supremacy.
Yeah.
Again, preferring to use those IL-2s, but to what end?
He's gonna try to bomb some light armor.
He's just gonna try to cannon it to death. Oh no!
87. Is he gonna go for the gun run?
Head to head.
Dude, those IO2s are resistant. He just took like 4 20 mils to the face, and he's only at half stress. Not even. Holy crap! Those things are absolute tanks.
Nah, mildly amused by the fact that we have not seen the bomb still getting dropped here. I'm not sure if he's using that as like a ploy to increase his time over target, or if it's just a very, very unfortunate deactivation. But
hey, it's just The only strafe and stuff with the cannons, which is definitely very interesting. Cool. Maybe he's waiting for the perfect target.
The perfect target, there we go. Yeah. One going down, and the shoot post in the front, and yep. Any target's a good target. You don't want to come back with bombs under your wings. It's kind of a waste then.
Mm-hmm. And people at the airbase laugh at you.
Yeah, well, think about it. Do you really want to land with ordnance under your wings?
Mm-hmm.
I don't.
Nope. There's been a lot of accidents because of that.
But in the meantime, of course, we are to phase B. So Solarwing Pixie does lose a little bit of his efficiency in terms of income, giving up a good chunk of that ground. But, I mean, look where he is already. What does Quark do to get back in this? That he's on, I honestly would argue that he's very much on his back foot. I don't know what he's supposed to be doing.
Yeah, it's not looking really too good for Sean. I mean, once we get Orion B phase now, so the income does start to help out. But Solo has a really good foothold on the other side of that river. And unless Sean has some actual quality infantry to come in, and maybe some quality, tanks, I think it's not going to go all that well for him.
Well, even if we're looking down to the south, we have these tiny moments of resistance, these shoot posts on the front lines. Then we have, Sapirzi coming through with rocks. We have these strokies that are just engaging all these guys from long range. It's just the base of fire is just too intense, I think, to even stop.
Yeah, and this is the perfect map for Pose, as it's nice, it's close quarters. Infantry can just kind of get in everywhere and be really deadly, as the Poes have some of the best infantry selection in game.
I am mildly amused by the continuation of having these, how do I call this, these shoot posts behind enemy lines, who just kind of throwing rounds down race at these, basically the Polish tank with the Santniki.
Oh.
And of course, these guys can't engage back because they only have a couple hundred meters of range. So,
this is a slow red tide on Sean's front.
Yep, it certainly seems that way. We have an 85, 88 millimeter we brought on in that kind of dual chamber anti-air piece.
Mm-hmm.
I understand what the role is overall in the division. I don't know exactly what that's supposed to do under these circumstances here.
Yeah. I mean, we were saying about anti-air earlier, but I think the massive ground rush is a little bit more important.
Yes. Yes.
And one big anti-tank gun, anti-everything gun, really, not going to be all that useful.
So honestly, he can keep the Yak at a good distance, but, Yeah. I mean, that's kind of all you can say right now.
Is there
one
something?
Of light vehicles, it's like, eh, yeah, I guess it's not worthwhile. But I don't like the. I don't like the current state of affairs for him. It's kind of rough.
Mm-hmm.
If only Korik was not just besotted with so much stressed out and disheartened infantry.
Yes, you do get some actual proper troops with the cavalry guys, if I recall. But this is going mainly for a lot of the disheartened or less regular challenge, which does make sense because you do get a lot of them at very rough road to take, but in a matchup against another infantry division that has the same amount of infantry but actually quality, it's tough. And we haven't seen, you need more ground support with your Shupos and whatnot to really make him run a trial.
Or your Landeschützen, or your Osttruppen, I mean, yeah, it's constant. It's a constant battle.
And the airplanes are just not, doing enough support. It's just too much stuff. Too many targets, really.
It would be nice if the IL-2s actually did in fact drop their bombs on something, and then try to engage, because I think that's probably one of the few things keeping Sean's planes as safe as they are.
Anti-air is doing a pretty good job now. I'll give him that.
Yeah.
But it's not enough against everything else.
Well, being out 18-6, it's going to happen, though, too. He got outnumbered early on. The quality was not with him. And, gravity is a heartless bitch. Yes, sir?
This is another run of hills. It's one of those maps where you really have to rush in hard early Or it's just gonna be a long stalemate.
Well, and that's always the issue that we had with the original game too, is that we had these really, really choke pointy maps, and it was impossible to get over them. I love the aggression. The aggression was absolutely wonderful, but we weren't backing up with enough artillery, weren't backing it up with immediate air support as opposed to kind of that delayed bit. And once the poles get going, that's like a rolling stone, man. It crushes that moss. It doesn't even gather it.
Yeah, the anti-air goes down. The commander's still alive, holed up in his little church. So we'll see how long he survives.
Well, right now he's doing the Oppum, the Corporal Oppum defense. He's not firing until he's fired upon. I mean, it's very respectable of him, very fair. One of these mano a mano stuff. But his troops are not going to come out ahead, especially when that tank comes on in too.
Yeah. I mean, he's in the perfect place to pray to God that someone will save him.
Yeah, but the Poles and the Soviet army, do they believe in God at this point? They pray to Lenin. I'm not sure. Once again, a very topical joke, which I probably will regret a couple years into the future when we are forced to live under Lenin. Oh, wow. Pack taking down a T-34E, that just kind of could have been menacing quite a bit here. I think Solo Wing Pixie over here is definitely riding that tide high here. Nothing too shocking. Would not say the fat lady has sung just yet, but she sure as hell is warming up.
All the sheepos. You don't have enough sheepo, bring in more.
Man, I really wish they were better.
And that would be a good game. I wonder what the kills will look like. Not that different really, considering it wasn't going that well for Sean.
But you gotta think about why, though, too. The sheepo is what, 15 points?
Yeah, they're like really cheap.
So if you
Very
want to
cheap.
count just raw numbers, I mean, I'm surprised there's any SS troops left.
Nothing too crazy on the kills, and nothing super crazy on losses either. Well, actually, one T-60 did pretty decent, considering it's like a T-60.
Yeah, sorry, one German T-60.
Another thing. The Russian tank, which side's using it? It's always a 50-50.
But unfortunately, that's what's going to happen. Poles are, if you let them get that early, advantage, they're going to steamroll you. Full
Yeah.
stop.
On certain maps, they're just really, really, really good. And this is one of those examples of them just being really good on this map. Other maps are terrible, but this one, fantastic.
But that's the ideal, though. I mean, that's when you get super lucky. But in particular case, though, Rang, any final thoughts?
None whatsoever.
Well, folks, in that case, then, I guess we'll see you in a couple of days with some more SD2 action. Until next time, I'm Conor Work.
I'm Rangru, take it easy.